Today, I'm going to talk about something that has been trending recently. It's called ChatGPT. Since ChatGPT launched in November 2022, it has crossed over 1 million users in less than a week. It's an AI-powered chatbot. It's currently free to use while it's in research preview. All you need to do is just sign up an account on openai.com. First thing you can use ChatGPT for is to generate ideas. It can actually provide suggestions like new product ideas or business strategies, and you can also use it to suggest keywords or any search terms for SEO, which is search engine optimization. Now, it can help generate some unique and innovative concepts. For example, I used ChatGPT to brainstorm for some good YouTube channel ideas, and here's what it suggested me. Some of the ideas I've mentioned in this video are, in fact, generated by ChatGPT. Another way to use it is to generate prompts for AI art. So for example, Guy Parsons has asked this question in ChatGPT. He typed in a one-liner question. It generated answers within a few seconds. He entered these prompts into Midjourney, which is an AI-powered system that generates images based on the user's prompts. So after that, here's what he got. Pretty awesome, right? The whole process probably takes less than a minute. Another way you can use AI for is writing. You can write a song, ask ChatGPT to generate an email draft, generate content for social media or blog, generate product descriptions or marketing copy. You can also use ChatGPT like a research assistant, and it will generate information on a wide variety of topics. If you own a business and you often need to do customer service yourself, you can basically use it like a customer service assistant where it gives you quick automated responses to common inquiries that your customers have. Another useful idea is to use ChatGPT to summarize a book. I have tried using it to summarize the book 4-Hour Workweek, and this is what it told me. Another mind-blowing thing that's trending on Twitter right now is its ability to write and debug code. What ChatGPT does is that it can identify the bugs in your code, fixes it for you, and explains the fix. I mean, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know what to feel about this. So Dave Williams asked ChatGPT to write a Figma plugin, and here's the mind-blowing results. This is seriously very awesome. Another interesting use case, Wilbert used ChatGPT to advise on his startup. He asked how can he make 10,000 MRR from his B2B SaaS product. Although the results generated are pretty generic and it's not 100% correct, after all, it's AI, not human, but I see a lot of potential here. I've also tried doing this. I told ChatGPT that I'm a designer and an educator and I feel like an imposter. And here's what it told me. It even remembers and retains context of what I asked in my questions and answer me based on that. I gotta say, this response is pretty good. You can also use it to entertain yourself. I've asked ChatGPT to tell me a joke and it never failed me. I also use it to get suggestions on random stuff. I asked ChatGPT if they can suggest me some creative Christmas gifts for my parents. There's also other use cases like using it to generate a recipe. Here is what you shouldn't use ChatGPT for and what are the limitations around it. It may generate incorrect information and it may occasionally generate some harmful instructions or offensive content, and it has limited knowledge of world events after 2021. It can't browse the internet for you and it cannot access information that it hasn't been trained on. Another disclaimer here, please don't use ChatGPT for bad things like generating inappropriate requests or do something terrible. So how you use ChatGPT is entirely up to your own creativity. Since AI has the ability to write, debug code, generate art, and so much more, what happens to humans? So I asked ChatGPT, will AI replace humans? And this is what it said. On a positive note, Sean Wang, a developer, has shared on Twitter that developers shouldn't be threatened by generative AI because in his perspective, AI helps us automate a lot of the boring stuff. In return, humans get to spend more time on valuable things. Instead of fearing AI taking over humans, let's embrace it and leverage on the technology and its intelligence to help us accomplish what we want to do. I'm not an expert, but I'm still learning about these new AI tools. I'm excited for what's to come. Many people are already saying that the responses of ChatGPT are better than Google search results. But is this the death of Google? I don't think so, but this is just the beginning. So what do you think about all of this? Have you tried out ChatGPT yourself? Comment below. ChatGPT is powerful, but I hope you're inspired based on this video and creative use cases that you can try out to help get more things done for you. If you like this video, here are more videos on solopreneurship and product design. I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.